Where should we be using dual function breakers? All right, so dual function breakers. What is a dual function breaker? It is not a combination AFCI breaker. CAFCI or combination AFCI devices are specifically arc fault breakers that detect two different kinds of faults. There's series faults and there are parallel faults, arc faults specifically. If you want to watch more, click the little bubble. I did a whole video on arc faults. But specifically, dual function are a type of breaker that was invented so that you could combine GFCI or ground fault protection with AFCI arc fault protection. So it's both functionalities. It'll both do the combination of series and parallel arc fault finding, as well as GFCI fault finding. Now, the cool thing with this is that typically, these breakers are more expensive. So like an arc fault breaker might be like $50. Again, depends on where you're at or anything like that. But generally, if you're looking at like an arc fault breaker, that's around $50. A dual function breaker is gonna be around that too, maybe like $60, something like that. So the cost of adding GFCI receptacles to an arc fault environment is roughly the same cost. So sometimes even cheaper. Sometimes a dual function breaker that does both, you don't have to have multiple different devices like an arc fault breaker over here and then a GFCI device to make sure that in a room like a kitchen where you have GFCI receptacles and you're still in a kitchen that's considered an arc fault environment, you can just combine all that into one device. So where do we need to put dual function breakers? If you look in code, there's specifically arc fault places. These are entire circuits. So they go by location. When you're arc fault protecting something, you're talking about a specific location and all of the branch circuits, the entire circuits have to be protected. If you're talking about GFCI ground faults, those are specifically receptacles, not necessarily locations. They're receptacles within specific locations, but you're not like GFCI protecting an entire bathroom. It's just receptacles within that bathroom. So you have to think kind of on the whole about what are the environments that need arc fault protection, and then within those environments, what receptacles in these environments actually have to have GFCI protection. So there's not a whole lot of places that have to have dual function breakers. And honestly, if you just wanted to put all arc fault breakers in a breaker in a panel and then go and take GFCI devices and put them everywhere, you can do that if you want to. But a lot of places, they're not smart to actually have a GFCI. Like you, in a kitchen, we have to put arc fault protection. The entire kitchen has to be arc faulted. Every circuit, all of the circuits within the kitchen have to have arc fault protection. But behind a refrigerator, you're not gonna put a GFCI device, because then if it trips, you gotta pull the whole refrigerator out and then trip that thing and put it back in. And you know, if you keep having nuisance tripping, like all your food could go bad and everything like that. So it just makes sense in that location to just have a dual function breaker out in your garage somewhere, or wherever your sub panel is at, and then you're covered under both of them. And then if something occurs and there's a trip, like all you have to do is go out to that panel, and then if the breaker goes bad or something like that, then you're just replacing that. But either way, you're not having to pull your refrigerator out each time there's an issue. So in code, there's two different places. There's 210.8 for GFCIs and 210.12 for AFCIs. So what I recommend people do is go with the arc fault stuff first and figure out the environments of where you're gonna be putting all of these things in as arc faults. So when I start running home runs, right, I'm running them out to a receptacle, I'm running them out wherever in the house, and then back at the panel where I'm gonna land all of these, I label each one of the home runs with what it's called. So I might label it like kitchen refrigerator. And then at the end of that, I put a little dash and I put AF. So I know for sure that that circuit needs to be arc fault protected. And I'm thinking about this as I'm doing it. I'm running something out. And when I was first starting doing it, I would write an entire list of all of, I would just put arc faults, and I would put a list of every single circuit that I knew had to be arc faulted, because I would go into 210.12B specifically, if you're looking in the 2013 electrical code, and I would figure out all of these rooms and what circuits needed to be arc fault protected. And then as I was running GFCI circuits, I would write next to those GF. And then when I got to a certain location that I realized, oh, this is an arc fault, but it's also a GFCI type of a thing, then I would just write DF next to it instead of arc fault or ground fault. So that kind of helped me to figure out which ones needed DF and which ones didn't. So very quickly, let's just break through what it says. I'm not gonna do the whole video again. You can go watch the arc fault video or the ground fault video if you want more specifics about these. But within dwellings, within houses or places that people dwell, it actually has in 210.12b dwelling units, and it lists these are the areas. It's all 120 volt single phase loads that are 10, 15, and 20 amp. Now that's not receptacles, that's entire branch circuits. So it could be lighting circuits, that could be appliances, that could be receptacles. So the entire circuit in these rooms, in kitchens, family rooms, dining rooms, living rooms, parlors, libraries, dens, bedrooms, sunrooms, recreation rooms, closets, hallways, and laundry areas. And then they put this cool thing that just says similar areas. A lot of like bigger custom homes, like stuff that I've dealt with, there's a lot of different rooms that are called weird different things. If they're kind of similar to any of these rooms, then you're gonna put arc fault protection on them. The way I like to think about it is I just arc fault protect everything, because as code cycles go on, normally we're expanding the reach of where these things are going to have to be installed. We're not like decreasing or taking things away. And I think as the years progress, you're gonna see more and more. And even the ground fault, we're only talking arc fault right now, but even the ground fault section keeps expanding. Now we have 240 volt loads that are added on to the GFCI requirements. So I think at a certain point, we're probably gonna get to a point where material in panels, are the breakers are smart enough to just detect both of them, and every circuit has that smart ability to detect all of them. So I kind of just generally think about the entire dwelling as needing arc fault protection. There are certain places that are not specifically required, and it's bathrooms and outdoors. So anytime you're looking, bathrooms, well, garages as well. Bathrooms, garages, and anything outdoors. So those are kind of the three areas that you don't have to put arc fault protection. But I mean, in all reality, like, that could be considered a similar area. It's a room, there's four walls, you go in and do stuff in the rooms, and then you leave, you know, it's within a dwelling. I understand that some things cause nuisance tripping, some appliances and things like that, so you can't put them on an arc fault breaker because internally, something, the machinery doesn't like whatever's happening inside that breaker. A lot of times nuisance tripping will happen where the breakers just trip for no reason. There's not actually a problem. It's just that they're detecting some kind of waveform or some event they're thinking is an arc because it has fundamental characteristics of an arc and it's very similar in some kind of way. So it causes breakers to trip. Generally, those are gonna be in garages. You might have things that you're plugging in a bathroom that are gonna cause the breaker to trip or nuisance trip. So that's kind of why they do it. But I think as you'll see, especially in code, that like they're putting things in here like arc welders. If you look in exception two of 210.12b, again, 2023 code, they have something in here about arc welding equipment. So it actually says AFCI protection is not required for individual branch circuits supplying an outlet for arc welding equipment, right? Because it's an arc detecting piece of equipment, this breaker, AFCI breaker, and an arc welder is an arc equipment. Like it produces arcs, and that's how it heats up and melts metal. So they're giving it a time, though. It says that up until January 1st of 2025. So manufacturers are going to have to figure this whole problem out. But there are, you know, again, I can just see the movement towards everything being on it. So that was a long rant to just say, I kind of just consider the whole house as arc fault. So when you think about this, think about these areas are eligible for dual function as well. But within these environments, what receptacles can be in these places that also in 210.8 require GFCI protection? So in dwelling units in 210.8, A, it talks specifically about dwelling units. B is other than dwelling units. So we're not putting arc fault breakers in like commercial buildings. It's always dwellings or, you know, places where people sleep and live that we're putting all of these things. But if you skip through B and go to C, now we're back to things that might actually be in dwellings, and D might be in dwellings, might be in both. E, F. So these things are things that could also be indwelling. So you just have to know if any of these receptacles are within an environment that's listed for arc fault, then you can put a dual function breaker on them. So I would just pick areas that it's a pain in the butt to go put a GFCI receptacle. If you're thinking about somebody living in this space, do you want them to like have to go under a counter and pull all kinds of cabinets and cleaning stuff out to put a GFCI receptacle in for a dishwasher when you could just dual function the whole thing and not have to have that? For a refrigerator, behind a refrigerator, do you want to have a GFCI receptacle behind that refrigerator? And you could just minimize it to that, to the inconvenient loads. But if you start thinking about how many, you know, depends where you're getting your materials, $8 to $25 GFCI receptacles that you're gonna buy, how many of those do you wanna add up and buy when you could just get a breaker that's roughly the same cost as an arc fault breaker, and then you've got coverage for everything neatly in one place rather than the homeowner having to run around through the house, figure out where all of these GFCI receptacles are at, not knowing if one of them's outside or tied into a laundry circuit or something like that. So that's kind of why I do it. So I usually pick the kitchen to put dual function breakers in for pretty much everything within a kitchen. So it says that everything in a kitchen has to be arc fault protected, but not necessarily everything in a kitchen needs to be dual function, because again, GFCIs are only the receptacles. It's a place where somebody can plug in and get shocked or electrocuted. So I would look into the ground fault stuff in 210.8, and in kitchens, it specifically says receptacles in kitchens. That's receptacles, period, in kitchens. There's a lot of receptacles in kitchens. There's like vent hoods, there's refrigerators, there's dishwashers, disposals, microwaves, all kinds of stuff. So all of those have receptacles in them and they're not direct wired, so they need to have GFCI protection, but the entire area of a kitchen is also arc fault. So you might have five or six different circuits that are arc fault protected within a kitchen, but you might only have like one or two of those that go to receptacles, and those are good candidates for putting dual function breakers. So anything in a kitchen, I would definitely put dual function if there's receptacles. Anything in a laundry area, so in 210.8, it says receptacles in laundry areas, but it also says in 210.12 for arc faults that laundry areas is one of the places that you need arc fault. So again, you've got multiple different receptacles. Some houses are really big and have crazy laundry areas. They might have countertop receptacles. They might have like weird charging receptacles. They might have a washer, dryer, things like that. So all of these receptacles have to have GFCI protection, but the entire room is also something that needs to be arc faulted. So you'll get, again, you might have like four or five arc fault breakers, but a couple of those might be dual functions to feed the receptacles so that you're covered under both. So you don't have to use dual function breakers. That's another thing I just want to point out, is you can just use arc fault breakers and put GFCI devices in. There are gonna be some circuits that you don't need either, that you can just be a regular single pole 20 or something like that. I like to just keep all fault finding to a panel so that you're not adding devices in multiple locations. If you think about smart design, how easy is something to troubleshoot? If you kind of cut down on all of the things that could go wrong and do go wrong, GFCIs just go bad. Like especially outdoor GFCIs, WRTR GFCIs, they just go bad. The elements outside, the nature of like the salt in the air and the moisture and all of that, like it's just exposed to the elements. So I like to try to keep anything that could go wrong to a minimum and reduce those things, so I'm not having like areas in a panel where something could go wrong and terminations there, and then terminations at a receptacle that could go wrong, and then the receptacle itself being some kind of electronic thing that could go wrong. You know what I mean? I try to minimize all of that stuff as much as possible. That's why I like using dual function breakers, because it takes multifunctionality and adds it, puts it one place. And most of the time I've found that the reliability of the breakers that have arc fault dual function or GFCI, most of the time those breakers are far more reliable and they're engineered a little bit better than these cheap little devices that you're putting in different places. So I just like to do that rather than adding multiple different devices. And then a lot of times too, you'll have, not so much nowadays, but there was a problem where you used to put like an AFCI breaker in and a GFCI receptacle, and sometimes it would cause something to happen where one of them would trip the other one, or if you plugged a certain load into a GFCI receptacle on an arc fault breaker, that it would the nature of whatever was happening inside that load would create one or both of them tripping. So it's just a personal preference. That's why I like doing it. But anyways, that is your dual function. Really, it's just in wet areas. That's where I would pay attention to this. As of now, it does not outline in code still that we have to do bathrooms and garages and outdoors. But again, I think planning for that for the future wouldn't hurt. So if you are interested in watching the kind of more deep dive where I talk about arc fault breakers, click here. If you want to watch more specifically about ground fault breakers, click here. Thank you guys so much for your attention. Love you crazy people, and I'll see you in the next one.